Okay, standing behind your chairs, ready for recess.
I've been teaching for over 30 years and I've been at the school for 9 years. I'm a trained kindergarten teacher, but all my teaching has been in the junior primary school. When I get to school in the morning, I set up the visual timetable. It lists the subjects and the order that we're going to do them during the day. It's made on a program called Board Maker. The Board Maker has a picture cue as well as the word, and that's good for the non-readers. This school's really embraced technology.
Okay, what day is it today? Alana. Friday. Can you find Friday?
I give the children a brain teaser every morning.
Sudoku?
Yes.
It just switches their brain onto school thinking and out of home thinking.
Any questions or comments?
Taylor. Did you go first?
I got fourth.
We have a daily sharing session. Four or five children each day have a turn.
My second favourite one was the sack race.
It's a good time for the children to show that they've taken on board the listening skills that I've been trying to introduce into the classroom.
Any questions or comments?
Jenna. The thing that's funny is on the board it's 1, 2, 3, 4 and there is 1, 2, 3, 4 on the race.
Asking questions is a difficult skill for young children. No. They don't understand that a question needs an answer. Often they'll think a question is telling you something.
When you've finished your look, say, cover, write, check, you can have a free choice of spelling activities. So we've got the blocks. I'll put drag a letter on the whiteboard. There's the iPods.
Part of the technology that has been introduced into this school are the iTouches. We've been using them in literacy throughout the year.
And look, ready? This is how I made it. I'm doing a mouse.
There's a boat in my pool. It is fun in there. And there's 25 children in the class. And there's a huge range of different levels.
Air.
There. Getting the letter sounds is the first step, and then putting them together to make the sounds, and then learning which spelling is the correct one for that sound in that particular word.
Do we say getting ready or ready?
Ready.
Ready. So what could you change in ready?
The happiest time for me in teaching is when all the talking, all the teaching, all the input I've given, you see it in the children's face and you think, they have been listening, it's all been worthwhile, they've got it.
Good spelling for recess, well done, because that's a really tricky one. In the bus to the museum, this one hasn't got the it in it. So.
Because there are non-readers in the class, a lot of visual clues around the classroom about listening and the rules of the classroom were formed in discussion with the children. They're fairly loosely based on the school's code of conduct as well.
Is that when we did the caterpillar?
Yeah, that's what the caterpillar is.
There are some students in the class who are just very volatile children. We've got suggestions on what they can do when they feel that they need to have just some chill time.
Hurry up, Rayleigh!
Sometimes they need some settling down time and some change-up time between different subjects that we cover. One of the games I like to do is, like Simon says, I change it a little bit.
Okay, hands on heads. See if you can follow my words, not my actions. Hands on shoulders. Hands.
Sometimes the children do like to close their eyes because that way they have to listen and they're not distracted by what they can see.
Everyone listening? William, I should be able to see your eyes. If I can see your eyes, I know you're listening. Chloe, eyes.
Often in the class, when I get the children's attention, there's a few that need extra reminders. So I might say, stop, you need to listen. And if I can see your eyes, then I'll know that you're listening.
If you still have food left, you need to be sitting down.
Being little children, they get very excitable. So sometimes is all they need.
When you've got your hat on, you may go.